Hi, welcome to Enchiridion. Torvosaurus was a carnivorous megalosaurid theropod dinosaur that lived roughly 165 to 148 million years ago, during the late Middle and Late Jurassic period, during the Callovian to Tithonian stages in what is now Germany, Colorado, and Portugal. It is two currently recognized species, including Torvosaurus tanneri and Torvosaurus gurneyi. A key field of study regarding Torvosaurus is its size and possible title of being the largest known Jurassic-era theropod dinosaur. Despite being known from only partial remains, fossils from the Morrison Formation have been compared to other better-preserved theropod genera, of the time to yield estimates to roughly 29.5 feet, or 9 meters long. Nonetheless, further fossil material like an upper jawbone, or maxilla, has been found to be larger than equivalent remains in North America, and when the North American remains are scaled up for comparison, a surprisingly high new estimate of up to 36 feet or 11 meters long is revealed. If the 36-foot long estimate is correct, then Torvosaurus claims the title for one of the largest predators in North America during the Jurassic, and may possibly even larger than the slightly smaller estimate for Saurophagnax, estimated to be between 33 feet and 42.5 feet or 10 to 13 meters. Yet this is the lower end of the estimate, and possibly Saurophagnax's upper bound would lead to it claiming the title of the largest. Due to its potential large size, Torvosaurus has been suggested by some to have been a scavenger that used its larger size to intimidate and scare off smaller theropods, like even Allosaurus, Ceratosaurus, and Marshosaurus from their kills. In spite of the proposed scavenger lifestyle, this large size may have well granted Torvosaurus an advantage in dealing with larger prey that would have been too slow to run away from a theropod the size of Torvosaurus. Potential prey for Torvosaurus could have included plated dinosaurs like Stegosaurus, and ornithopods like Camarasaurus, sauropods like Camarasaurus, Apatosaurus, Diplodocus, and Brachiosaurus are also known to have been widespread, and smaller juveniles of these genera would have been more vulnerable to predators like Torvosaurus. Another supposed large theropod known as Enchiridion is known to have dwelled in North America during the Jurassic. Nonetheless, recent speculation that Enchiridion may have actually been the same dinosaur as Torvosaurus has increased in popularity. In 2000, new theropod material was recovered from Portugal, and found that a description by Octavio Matthews and Miguel Tejas Antunes assigned these fossils as Torvosaurus. Later in 2006, the fossils from the Lorena Formation were assigned to the type species Torvosaurus tanneri. By 2012, an additional study by Carano et al. Went to point out that the Torvosaurus fossils could be defined further than just a generic species, and in 2013, eggs with fossilized embryos inside them were assigned to Torvosaurus. Finally, in a 2014 description by Hendricks and Matthews, the Portuguese fossils were recognized as a species entirely separate from the type species which is nowadays only known from North America. The Portuguese Torvosaurus are now credited as belonging to Torvosaurus gurneyi, a species named in honor of James Gurney, who is best known for his work creating the Dinotopia series of illustrated books. It might seem weird that two species of the same dinosaur could coexist on separate continents, yet the late Jurassic North America and Europe were closer and still connected, and land animals could walk between the two. Torvosaurus is also not the only one either, with species of other dinosaur genera, which are often described as North American, like Allosaurus, Stegosaurus, and Ceratosaurus, also being known from the Portuguese Lorena Formation. In fact, many researchers often point out that in terms of the types of animals, the Lorena Formation is analogous to the famous Morrison Formation of the United States. Other dinosaur genera that Torvosaurus gurneyi may have come into contact with included Stegosaurus merogaea and Dasyntrurus, the sauropods Lysotitan, Alarinosaurus, the theropod Lurihanosaurus, as well as ornithopods and possibly even Ankylosaurus. Torvosaurus gurneyi was first described as being about 36 feet or 11 meters long, yet revisions to this estimate have already been made, which has seen estimates reduced to around 33 feet or the 10 meters mark. This would still make Torvosaurus gurneyi one of the largest theropods known to have lived in Europe, and still larger than many of the earlier European theropods like Megalosaurus, Dobrilosaurus, Pokylopleuron, and Magnosaurus. It was a large, heavily built bipedal carnivore that could grow to a length of 33 feet, as we have mentioned, or 10 meters long. Torvosaurus tanneri was among the largest carnivores of its time, together with Saurophaganax and Abentirid, both of which may actually be synonyms for Allosaurus. Specimens referred to Torvosaurus gurneyi were first claimed to be up to 39 feet or 12 meters long, but later shown to be smaller. Based on bone morphology, Torvosaurus is thought to have had short but very powerful arms. It had an elongated narrow snout, with a kink on its profile just above the large nostril. Torvosaurus means savage lizard. The genus name Torvosaurus derives from the Latin word torvus, meaning savage, and the Greek word sauros, meaning lizard. It was named by Peter Galton and James A. Jensen in 1979. It belongs to the kingdom Animalia, the phylum Chordata, the clade Dinosauria, Saurischia, Theropoda, the family Megalosauridae, the subfamily Megalosaurini, the genus Torvosaurus, and the type species being Torvosaurus tanneri. The following is a cladogram based on the phylogenetic analysis conducted by Carano, Benson, and Sampson in 2012, showing the relationships of Torvosaurus. Synonyms include Admarca. Species include the type Torvosaurus tanneri and other species like Torvosaurus gurneyi. It was a carnivore. It is typically estimated to have been between 29.5 and 33 feet, or 9 and 10 meters long, though sometimes credited to be as much as 36 feet or 11 meters long. It has been found in Colorado, the Morrison Formation in the United States, and in the Lorena Formation of Portugal. Studies suggest that the paleoenvironment of the Morrison Formation may have included rivers that flowed from the west into a basin that contained a giant saline alkaline lake, and there were extensive wetlands close by. It coexisted with other large theropods like Allosaurus, Ceratosaurus, and Saurophaganax. It lived during the late Middle and Late Jurassic, from the Callovian to Tithonian stages, roughly 165 to 148 million years ago. Fossil representation includes partial postcranial remains and sections of the skull, including the maxilla. Additional remains are thought to possibly be attributable to the genus. Thank you for watching this program episode of Dinosaurs and Other Shorts. Under the Jurassic period Morrison Formation meat eaters, I had a lot of fun making these short ones, and I plan to learn more about using software like Blender to sculpt 3D models and possibly animate the creatures to create very high quality documentaries on these great and interesting prehistoric beasts. I'm very excited about the new projects we have planned for this channel. They're certainly very fun, and I'm learning a lot in the process. Thank you for your positive feedback. It helps me keep going, and as always, this is Enchiridion. See you next time.